The reveal.
All right. Ready?
Yeah.
Thank you, Bailey. Thank you so much. Yay, it's piano day.
It's piano day.
Ah, with a little guitar. Ooh, that was fun. That was Bailey. We did that at a high school, at her high school one time. They had a talent show, and we did that. We rocked it. Yes, we did. How are you today? It's day 35. Lord have mercy, day 35. But yep, that's the day it is. And it's piano day. We love piano day around here. Don't we? We move everything out to the piano room. So much going on. I'm going to be really busy tomorrow. Tomorrow's 420, and some of you don't know what 420 is. That's okay. I think it's an American term, I guess. 420 was a time of day that a group of college kids would get together and enjoy cannabis. And it became the 420 Club, and 420 just became just a slang term for cannabis. So tomorrow, you know, it's a family show, so we won't be, you know, doing anything crazy. But I think tomorrow, lots of long guitar solos. That's what we'll have tomorrow. Oh, I had so many requests for different songs on Piano Day. I'm going to start doing more cover songs because I kind of run out of songs of mine on the piano. But I did this next song. I was asked to do this. This was around 2007 or 8, right around there. And it was a time when Dolly Parton was being recognized again and in the early 2000s. And I was going to do the Oprah Winfrey show, and it was going to be me and Dolly and Shania Twain and Alison Krauss. Really great show, just a really cool show. And it was to celebrate this sort of tribute to Dolly that artists got together and did. So everyone, you know, picked their favorite Dolly song. And at this point, I hadn't even met Dolly Parton. And they said, we would like you to do I Will Always Love You. And that song has been, well, not only is it a great Dolly Parton song, but it was done by one of the greatest singers on earth, Whitney Houston, right? And that song could not be more iconic and such. So I sort of went, well, okay, but I didn't want to try to out-sing anybody. So I kind of took a restrained approach to the song, which kind of made it a little stalkery and a little creepy. We sort of laughed when we did it, but it's on the Dolly Parton tribute. I ended up doing the Oprah Winfrey show with her and just loved her. And a couple years later, not even, maybe just a year later, she asked me to be on her Crossroads, which is, it was on CMT or MTV, the country music television. And it's when two artists get together and do each other's songs. And oh, I was so honored and I had so much fun with her. And I got to ask her about this song. And she told me that it was written for Porter Wagoner, who had kind of discovered her. He put her on his little television show. And she was obviously ridiculously talented, and she was ready to branch out on her own. And so she wrote this song for him, saying that it wasn't as he was a lover, just like she sent him lots of love and had to go on her way. And, you know, with Dolly, you never really know what's going on with her, do we? We never do. But we love her so much. So, yeah. If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go. But I know I'll think of you each step of the way.
that's all I'm taking with me. So goodbye, please don't cry, 'cause we both know I am not what you need. And I will always love you. I will always love you. And I hope life treats you kind. You have all that you dreamed of, and I wish you joy, and I wish you happiness, but most of all, I wish you love. Thank each and every one of you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, so good, Piano Day. Ah, look, I remembered my water. So, day 35, we're holding on. Sometimes Sunday just feels different, the weekends. I think it's important for us to recognize the weekends, you know? to make sure we relax on the weekends. Even though we do a lot of relaxing during the week, it's important to really relax. So I don't do anything else today. Some of you are already gonna go to bed after this in Europe and stuff, and some of you are having dinner on the East Coast. Oh, we got so many people watching in the United States and Canada, and Europe and Brazil, of course, and the UK, Scotland, Ireland, Northern Ireland, hello, Belfast, and Australia, New Zealand, and wherever you're watching from. I'm gonna do a song now from Fearless Love. Now, I wrote this song because, you know, like I told you, I went through breast cancer 15 years ago, 15 years cancer-free, yay, thank you. And that experience really, really energized me about life. Mm-hmm. Helped me really get focused about the spirit of life and really taking it on and really wanting to be here. Because when you have one of those experiences where you're like, oh, you know, I could have checked out. This could have been the end. And you think, oh, I'd have missed so much. And so I thought I'd write a song about, oh, no, no, it's going to take more than that to get rid of me. You're going to have to drag me away. Did you think that I was leaving? It was just one way. The angels I believed in were gonna carry me away. Did you think that I would simply give them my last breath? Well, honey, you got me wrong. I'd never leave you for death. Gonna take more than
dynamite to get rid of me. It's gonna take more than that to make me fade. Oh, they'll have to tie me up, drag me away. They'll have to shut my mouth, drag me away. Hey, hey. There is no one I serve. Be a hostage to my own dis-ease. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on out and hold me. I'm into the great sunlight. No power on earth can stop us. We both become one tonight, yeah. I've never been more sure. Never been more sure of what I am. They'll have to tie me up and drag me away. They'll have to shut my mouth and drag me away. Now, there's no dark that can overcome a flame. There's no force that can drag.
Of destruction won't even up the score. Okay, so when I was looking around for other songs to do, I came across something very interesting. Let me tell you, when I was much younger, when I was in high school, I played in bands. I played in country bands. Then I played in like top 40 bands in the late 70s. We do the Bee Gees and Fleetwood Mac and stuff like that. Pardon me. It was, a lot of fun. I played, but then my senior year, right before I went to Berklee College of Music, I had that summer off. I was like, I'm not gonna play. I'm just gonna be a crazy kid. Of course, my dad was like, you need to make money, and he said, why don't you go play solo? Why don't you go ask the Ramada Inn? There was one Ramada Inn in Leavenworth. If you would go play, if you can go play and work. And I'll be darned, it's a family show. They gave me work. They said, yeah, I played there 5 nights. And sometimes there was nobody in there. I think I made $25 a night or something. And sometimes some army guys that were just passing through were there. That was fun. We used to sing, "You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille." But we did that two or three times. The more they drank, the more we sang it. But so that experience helped me when I went to Boston and wanted to start working in Boston. And so I went to all these bars and restaurants, and about the third or fourth one I went to was Ken's by George on Boylston, right there. It's, I don't know what it is, it's still a restaurant, but it was a place, it was a piano bar. No, it wasn't a piano bar, it was a restaurant with a lounge with a piano in it. And I would play mostly piano songs, that's what I did, and then every now and then I'd get up and play the guitar. So before, when I was playing the Ramada Inn, is what I want to talk about, my father, who loved to help me with these things, helped me put together a notebook. And I found that notebook today. And this notebook here. Ah. Can we see it? You want me to move in? Are you all right? Okay. This notebook, I don't know why, it's got its security insurance manual. I don't know why, but it's a great notebook. It's got like metal bindings. And I would buy sheet music, and I would go to the music store back when they sold sheet music, and I would tear the pages out, and I would put holes in them, and I'd put little holders right here so that it wouldn't rip through, and I would then go play in a restaurant or a bar or something. Look, here's the list I made right there. It's so funny. Smells old, it's all yellow. What are the songs? Oh my gosh. The first one, you remember, Air Supply? I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. Oh, come on, it was the beginning of the 80s, the end of the 90s. Brandy, Already Gone. Ah, and this is the song I chose to do for you today. Because this song, I wasn't terribly familiar with it, but I used to get requests for it all the time in Boston. I realized I actually played, the restaurant was around the corner from a women's bar. Imagine that. And what would happen is sometimes people would go eat there before they went to the bar, and they liked the way I sang. And they would ask me for this song, and I would say, I don't know it. And then I finally, I purchased it. And the version that I purchased was by Jane Oliver, if anybody knows that. If you were a young lesbian in the 80s, you might know who Jane Oliver is. She wasn't out. I don't even know if she's gay, but her hair was gay. Let's just say that. I don't think she's gay, but her hair was gay. And she used to sing, and she was like that torch singer, you know, that really, she was sort of a Barbara Streisand-ish. But this song that she used to sing was done by Captain and Tennille. It was done famously by Melissa Manchester, and Melissa Manchester actually wrote this song with Carol Bayer's Sager, an absolute amazing songwriter, wrote so many songs in the 70s and 80s that you know and love. And I used to sing the song, and just the gays loved it. It's one of those gay songs from the 80s, late 70s. And it's, I'm going to play it for you now. And I don't know what else to say, except I used to love doing this song.
For yourself for such a long time. There's so much to say, no need to explain. just an open door for you to come in from the rain. It's a long road when you're on your own, and one like you will always choose the long way home. There's no right or wrong, I'm not here to blame. I just want to be the one to keep you from the rain, from the rain. And it looks like sunny skies now that I know you're all right. Time has left us older and wiser. I know I am. And it's good to know my best friend has come home again, and I think of us like an old cliche, but it doesn't matter, 'cause I love you anyway. Left us older and wiser. I know I am. And it's good to know my best friend has come home again. I think of us like an old cliche, but it doesn't matter, 'cause I love you anyway.
Coming from the rain. Fun. Maybe I'll do more in here. I've got so many, look, so many songs, and they're all transposed because no one ever sings in my key. Oh, that's funny. A lot of Barry Manilow songs. We could do a Barry Manilow day, I'm just telling you. Maybe not. We will do a Bruce Springsteen day this week. Yes, we're going to rock. We have 420 tomorrow, a lot of guitar solos, I'm just saying. And I'm also on it'll be after the show tomorrow. I'll let you know exactly what it is, sort of a 420 benefit thing. I love you all. Thanks for tuning in today. What? No, it's okay. It's all right. I'd like you to wait. But thanks for tuning in today. I will be here tomorrow and the next day, and the next day, and the next day, and the next day, because I'm at least going to be here till May 15th, every day, 3 o'clock, lifting us all up, giving us something to do, because we have so much fun coming into your living rooms. Thank you for coming into ours. It's all right. Be strong. Be strong. Speak true. Spread the peace. Choose only love, it's a choice. Be kind to yourself here, be kind to yourself here, then you can be kind to others. All right, see you tomorrow. We're sending you much love. Bye-bye.